Okay, in the last video, we discussed briefly something called the celestial sphere, and we came up with the definition of it. And we're going to say, for the purpose of this definition here, that the celestial sphere is something that sort of contains all stars, planets, the sun, and the moon. And we're just going to sort of pretend that all of these objects are sort of printed on the inside of a round blanket. And I should probably go ahead and add the word large in here. Large blanket. And what's this blanket going to do? It's going to cover the Earth and rotate around it. And lastly, in the model, we see here that we're going to say that in this model, the Earth does not rotate. So see, we see a very bizarre occurrence right here, and maybe it's not even clear why we would do this in astronomy here, because this seems to imply here that the sky rotates. And this line here seems to imply that the Earth does not rotate. But we know neither one of those are true. But it turns out in physics, it doesn't really matter what you're talking about here, as long as one is moving with respect to the other. So in the actual world, we know that the Earth rotates and the sky is still. But in this model, we're going to let the sky rotate and the Earth be still. So as long as the relative speed between them are the same, we would sort of expect that the relevant things we see are going to be similar, and indeed that is true. But I'm just telling this to highlight this fact here, that I put these stars around these points here, that this idea of the celestial sphere is just a model. Just a model, okay? It doesn't represent physical reality, but sometimes when you come up with a good model, which the celestial sphere continues to be here, it really helps to, a good model here, let's see, helps to visualize. Visualize important aspects of something, maybe a model of the stock market, or some model of the world, I don't know, something like that. But it's just a model, as we'll see. So what we're proposing then, let me give you a sketch here, then I'll show you some actual good graphics of it here, is something like this. The celestial sphere obviously proposes then, the model proposes that the Earth is going to sit in here like this. There's the Earth, not spin. And then this is the weird thing, is this really big blanket now that you're going to cover the Earth with like that. So this gray thing here is the blanket, and I'm going to try to have a little three dimensionality to it. So let me go ahead and take that equator off the Earth and go back to the blue here, sort of draw the equator more like that to try to bring a little three dimensionality about it here. And we'll also sort of draw an equator around the blanket here, and we'll draw a north and a south pole there as well. And so there's a couple of things about the model already you can see here, is that for the Earth, of course, this axis sticking out is the North Pole, and this one down here is the South Pole. We've seen those a couple times in previous videos. Well, this little tick mark right here is going to be called the Celestial North Pole. And this one down here is going to be called the Celestial South Pole. And guess what? This line right here is going to be called the Celestial Equator. Just like this blue line in here on the Earth is what we know as our actual equator. Say that the sun passes over twice a year, right? So we have all these things sort of as the definition, but in a nutshell at the moment here, this gray blanket is the celestial sphere. Now, where are the stars and the planets and the moons and everything? Well, we said that they're painted on the inside of this thing behaving like a blanket. So if we could then, we're just sort of going to put the stars on that inside surface like that. On the inside surface of this, everywhere you go, is going to be the sun and some stars. So I'll draw a little bunch of white dots here, which will be the stars. And maybe I'll try to smash the sun right on in there. And we know that the moon is usually big and white. We'll talk about that. We'll sort of put that right there. We'll just put everything on the inside of that blanket. And then the last thing about model about the celestial sphere is that the Earth here is going to be still, not going to move, but this whole blanket now is the thing that's going to rotate. So you'd have to agree with me then, if you were standing here on the Earth somehow, the way we've drawn a few times before, would you see stars moving above your head? Yeah, you sure would, because we're just letting the Earth be still now, but if we let the whole sky rotate, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference that it was the sky rotating and the Earth not rotating, or the Earth rotating and the sky not rotating. Like, what evidence do you have that when you go outside and look at the sky, that it's you on the Earth that is rotating and not the sky itself? Okay, so that's the model. And in the next video, I'll show you some nice animated simulations.